policy. I have a Terry Malevsky, CBC, please.
Prime Minister, good morning. You just said that you thought that the parties should pay for the campaign, not taxpayers. And a lot of voters are bound to find that a very odd statement, considering that you have just loaded tens of millions of dollars of additional costs on taxpayers by deciding to have a much longer campaign in which, not coincidentally, you will have a chance to spend far more than your rivals. Taxpayers will have to subsidize the parties, the candidates, and they'll have to pay more for Elections Canada. Why should voters not conclude that you're giving yourself a financial edge because maybe you think that's the only way you can win?
Well, first of all, I'll go back and say what I just said. The reality is this, Terry. Everybody knows the election date, and the campaigns of the other parties, as near as I can tell, have already begun. I'm beginning our campaign today. I feel very strongly that if we're going to begin our campaigns and going to run our campaigns, that those campaigns need to be conducted under the rules of the law, that the money come from the parties themselves, not from the government resources, parliamentary resources, or taxpayer resources. And that's what we're doing. In terms of the advantages this party has, in terms of the fact that we are a better financed political party, a better organized political party, and better supported by Canadians, those advantages exist whether we call this campaign or not. What we do by calling this campaign is making sure we are all operating within the rules and not using taxpayers' money directly.
Merci. On continue avec Denis Ferland, RDI.
Hello, Mr. Harper. Mr. Harper, when you presented the bill on fixed election date in Victoria in 2006, you were saying that you want to stay away from the practices of manipulating the electoral calendar for your advantage. Are you saying here that there's no advantages for you to launch these elections? We're saying maybe two times longer than a regular campaign. On the contrary, I respect the reality. All parties know the fixed date of the elections already, and other parties have already started their campaign. It's essential to start now, that we start our campaign. It's essential that every party respect the rules, and the campaigns are submitted to the rules. We don't use the parliamentarian resources, but the resources out of the parties themselves. Now, in terms of the advantage, the fact is that we're better financed than the others, the fact that we're better organized than others, better supported from volunteers, Canadians, those are advantages that are already there. Whether there's the launch of this election at this time or not. Now, my opinion is pretty strong on this reality. If we go on a campaign like other parties, it's necessary for us to go ahead within the rules and do it within the rules. And we know, all of us know, the date of those elections and the rules.
Good morning, Prime Minister. Just a second ago, you talked about, you know, sound economic management. Your opponents have basically made this a little bit about change in this campaign and said that it's time for a change because your plan isn't working given the economic indicators we saw, you know, we've seen over the past couple of weeks. Why should Canadians continue to trust your plan for the economy? And as well, what is specifically in that plan that you're going to promise to Canadians that would actually turn around what we've seen in a shrinking economy?
I think our plan has proven itself over a long number of years now. Canada has consistently, not every month, not every week, but over a period of 6 years now, we have consistently outperformed other major industrial economies. We have a balanced budget. Most of them don't. We have the lowest debt levels by far. We have the soundest financial system. We are not cutting our budgets. We are making investments in critical things like trade and training and innovation and infrastructure. And that is why, you know, you look at all the major forecasters, all the major international agencies, they all predict that Canada's growth prospects are the best of G7 countries over the long haul. Now, look, the change that is being proposed, let's be clear what the change is that's being proposed. We have given Canadians a low-tax plan with disciplined financial management. What the other guys are proposing is a high-tax plan, big hikes in spending to lead to permanent deficits as a way of dealing with temporary economic challenges. That is a formula that has been disastrous in other countries. It's why they don't perform over the long haul as well as Canada, and we will contrast our low-tax plan focused on jobs and growth with their high-tax plan focused on simply growing the size of government.
Thank you. We'll continue with Laurie Graham from CTV.
Prime Minister, I understand you say you want to save taxpayers' money, you want all of the leaders under the same rules of Elections Canada, but by triggering this election, a 78-day campaign, the fact of the matter is the cost of this election campaign goes up exponentially, and taxpayers are indeed on the hook for more money. So how do you square a 78-day campaign that is at least 50% more than a 37-day campaign?
Well, I would challenge the premise of the question. But I would say this, it is important once again, as I say, that every political party's campaign be financed by itself, not government resources, not parliamentary resources, not of all the other resources that are available to us when campaigns are not on. Everybody is campaigning, everybody should finance their own campaign, and everybody should operate under the law and the rules for campaigns. And I don't think it is appropriate at all that campaigns be done all out outside the campaign rules. And look, I think if I started my campaign without declaring it, I think everybody here would be the first to criticize us for doing that. We are taking what is the appropriate and the right thing to do.
Merci. On va terminer avec Ray Fillion, TVA.
Bonjour, Monsieur Harper. Deux questions.
Questions for you. One on the economy first. You're presenting yourself as the best manager of the economy, but since you arrived, 7 years out of nine, your government had deficits. You've added billions of dollars to the public debt. Canada is at the door of a recession, and the deficit is we're heading into it once again this year. Why Canadians should keep as a manager of the economy yourself? And the second question, the cost of those elections, do you acknowledge that the fact that you're launching these elections today, it will cost much more to taxpayers? First, on the reality of the economy, the reality is that Canada already has a balanced budget. We are in a surplus situation for the two first months of this fiscal year. And the results right now are above the budgetary provisions. And we have already a balanced budget in Canada. We have the debt that is the lowest of the G7 economies by a very wide margin. And for a large period of time, we had a better performance on growth, on jobs, than other G7 countries, than other major industrialized countries. And the provisions of the large international organizations are saying that with our economic plan, this will continue despite of the difficulties of the last few months. Now, the choice is clear. We have a plan that is focused on the reduction of income taxes for families of Canadian workers and an economic management that is disciplined. Other parties will want to change this. Their economic policy that would lead to an increase of taxes and income taxes and the large expansion of the expenses. And our choice works. The results are clear. Other parties, you can see their policies in other countries. It's a disaster. Now, in terms of the cost of elections, once again, the elections have already started. The campaign has already started. We have a fixed date. Other parties have started their campaign already. It's essential, in my opinion, remains very strong on this. It's essential that we use our own party funds, not funds from the government, from the parliament, but the funds that comes from the parties themselves. If I started my campaign without launching an election, everyone everyone would criticize me in any case. So what I'm doing here is the correct thing. There is a campaign. It's necessary to respect the rules and to use our own funds and to work within the rules of the law. Thank you.